Yankee and a Brit. Hey, I'm here. Totally unprepared for that. But here we is.
Yes, we is. Good evening, Friday night, and you gorgeous guys and girls that are out there listening tonight. You guys in the chat room, and those of you that are out there listening while you're doing your dishes or having a big poo. You know how it goes. So hello to everybody out there. And in the chat room tonight, there is Brenda the Blender.
Hi, Brenda.
She says she's a cold blender tonight, so she's going to whip up some icy treats for the gentlemen and the ladies of the chat room.
Icy treats?
Icy treats of the chat in the chat room tonight.
Icy treats, but they better not be cold.
Erica K. Fultz is in the chat room tonight. Oh, and guys and girls,
Erica.
She has a couple of new tunes. She is going to blow your socks off with the new tunes. Who else do we have? We have Thomas.
Sounds exciting. I've had my socks blown off for about 4 years now.
I don't even wear any, but she's going to blow off me socks anyway. Benny Pitzinger is in the chat room. We have a new tune by Benny tonight.
Benny in his
and
new
tune.
And
we have some new music by the Purple Dubs, that band from Scotland.
That's right.
So we've got
and
some awesome
Johnny Black's
for you.
Got a new
Johnny
tune.
Johnny Black, too. Yes, yes.
Lots
oh
of new
gosh.
Music, too. We're plus just a little rock. That's why it's kind of a wide-open night, whatever you guys want to do. I see Thomas has a request over here.
We are just oozing, and I mean oozing, coming out of our arse with fantastic music tonight.
Oh, I see Thomas wants to get loud over here. So. All right, we'll get loud.
Well, you've given
one
that feeling, haven't
there.
You? You started up the show. Is my mic even on? I can't even hear it.
Yeah.
You sounds started right. up the show with some rock. And now he's got his guitar in his hand, his dick in his other hand, and he's ready to rock out.
We haven't done a rock night in a long time.
No. Mr. Chieko was asking about a Golden Oldies show, and I think we should do one next Friday night. I'm hoping that we can do one next Friday night, if you guys are all up for it. This is a night where Mr. Chieko chooses a big wagon load of tunes for the night, and we just jam our arses off.
And we all do The jitterbug and the electric slide and electric slide. How'd I come up with that?
I have no idea.
The jitterbug, anyways. Oh, those cool old dances.
And what was that song I was jamming to this morning?
The hell if I know. Oh. You always got three or four going.
You played it on YouTube for me because it was driving me mad. You know the one.
I don't remember.
Brenda says works for me. So Brenda's up for a Golden Oldies night.
Good.
Oh, look at Niecy in the chat room demanding again. She's demanding Love Shack. She wants her song and she wants it now.
Hello, Niecy.
She wrote it in capital letters because she knows what she wants.
Hello, Thomas. How are you, lad? Doing all right then? Good deal. Yeah, I got a blasting friggin' headache, so don't expect too much out of me. I had a good
what? Oh, I mean, hello.
Doesn't help any.
Carol Mojave Beach Band is in the chat room.
Oh, Carol, and we have Southern Wind loaded up over here somewhere down the list.
I have got some Southern Wind of my own going on tonight, as you guys probably know. Hey, we have some news. We have some news in the chat room. Where's my button? Where's my echo button?
All right, what is it?
We have some news. This is Donna from the Yankee and the Brit Show reporting that on the 14th of October, Erica in the chat room is going to be joining us for an interview. Beep, 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 beep. You're supposed to help me with sound effects.
Oh, it sounded great. You didn't need any help.
Should have given me a bit of a... That's the one.
Okay.
So yes, we officially have more people on the guest list, and we also have Johnny Black listed for Sunday the 25th.
I guess there's some
November
part of
too.
That I have a screaming headache over here that you just don't understand, and you're like, you gotta make noise. I don't want to make any noise. I haven't had one like this in a long time.
What, you ain't had a screamer? You ain't gave me a screamer in a long time. Are you rolling your eyes over there? I wish you guys could see him right now.
My
He's rolling
hurts.
His eyes.
I'm not joking about the headache. Seriously.
Well, put on a tune then. And let these guys
Oh, that'll
jam.
Help, especially what Thomas wants to hear. That'll make the old headache work. Oh.
Kryptonite's not a bad tune. Good choice, Mr.
No,
Chieko.
No, that's all right. It's just fine. Nothing wrong with that.
Kryptonite. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. So, yeah, next Friday night, Golden Oldies. If you have any Golden Oldie requests, you know what to do. Either post them on the Yankee and the Brit page or pop them over to my inbox on Facebook, or you can email them to us at yankeeandthebrit@gmail.com. Send over your requests.
That's right.
Nisi says that she's been busy writing more tunes, I guess.
Who has?
Nisi says that she's been busy writing. Oh. Thomas is ready to rock the head away.
I bet he is. All right. Well, then I guess we'll get to it, shall we? Make sure I got everything all organized over here.
What is everybody eating tonight? The reason I ask that is because we've just had a Fruits of the Forest strudel. It's very nice, wasn't it?
Not bad at all, really.
Not bad, I say, old chaps. Not bad.
I don't care for the tart berries that are in there. But
oh, I just
everything
want berries.
Else is good. I'm going to get apple next time.
I don't want apple next time. You can have apple, but I'm not having apple because I hate when they put caramel in everything. Mm. Blair. Blair, blair. Look who's in the chat room.
Hello, Sean.
Sean Adam Williams.
Hey, we got his tune in lined up.
Yes, we do. We have Sean's tune lined up too. We've had that lined up earlier. Now, Benny, what the bloody hell is Oyster Po' Boys? I saw him write on Facebook. What the bloody hell is one of them then? Is this another crazy American word?
No. Remember when we went to, was it New Orleans or Florida? We stopped at Po' Boys and ate?
I thought that was called Po' Folks. Po' Folks.
I thought we went to Po' Boys.
No, it was called Po' Folks. I got it
was
in
it
my
Po'
photo.
Folks?
Yeah, that was nice food. If that's the kind of thing that Benny went to, that's kind of yummy.
I don't know if they're the same place or not, to be honest with you.
Oh, look at that. Mr. Chieko is eating a mint ice cream sandwich. Now that is to die for right now. Deep fried oyster Po' Boy sandwich. Oh my God. Is that oysters in there, or is that just the name of the sandwich?
It's oysters.
Oh my God.
Slip them up.
Benny. Ugh.
You like to watch Mr. Bean eat them.
I do not like to watch Mr. Bean eat them. I love Mr. Bean with all my heart, with all my being, but he makes me laugh so much, and sometimes he makes me wrench, you know, like I want to throw up, but he still makes me laugh so hard that it hurts.
Thomas is having burgers and tater tots.
Burgers and tater tots. Benny says it's fried oysters on a bun with some kind of sauce that sounds like remolade.
Got me. I don't eat that stuff, so I don't know. I wouldn't put an oyster near my face.
No,
mint
me neither.
Ice cream.
Now, I've always loved mint chucky chip ice cream. And I've just not had it over here. Remoulade.
What kind of shrimp are you having?
Look, remoulade is a condiment invented in France that is usually aioli or mayonnaise based, through similar to tartar sauce. There you go. We are educating ourselves tonight here on the Yankee and the Brit Show.
Oysters put lead in your pencil. Hi, Al.
Hey, well, everybody.
Husband,
what's going on?
Eat some oysters then.
How you doing? Okay.
Out for the radio, dog.
Do you need something?
Yeah. Can I go out again?
Well, you haven't been out in a while, have you?
You haven't said hello to Erica in the chat room. You've met everybody else.
Hi, Erica. How are you?
And have you chewed on Benny's leg today? He's got a wooden leg, and we all know where Benny's wooden leg has been.
No.
It's been up Grandma's backside.
That's Granny's dildo.
Granny's dildo.
That's why I was chewing on it. It's had a good smell to it.
Oh, you're disgusting.
Out for the radio, dog. Yeah?
Hi, Mom. You okay?
This big boy, he is just amazing. Because he's a Great Dane and he's so big, he actually sits at table height with us, with plenty of room to spare, so he just sits there, stands there comfortably.
And Benny will be proud of him. He gets an oyster bib around him when he eats.
An oyster bib?
Yeah, you tie the bib on so he can eat. You know, Mr. Bean puts the napkin in his shirt. What are you doing?
He's sniffing your bell end. I mean, your knob. I mean, your shirt trousers.
I smell cheese, Bob.
Get out of here. Get.
Does the dog smell? Did you smell cheese, Alfred?
Come on, back up. You're drooling on the mouse over here. Come on, back.
There you go.
All right, you got to go outside. We got music to play. Let's get on with it over here. What do you say, Bradley?
I say, old chap, I say.
Hit
sounds
it,
like
hell.
A lovely cup of tea.
Let's get it down.
Let's rock this shit! With the Yankee and the...
Ruh-roh. What happened?
What?
I just lost everything for some reason. It all just disappeared. Well, ain't that a bitch and a half? Sorry. I don't know what happened. Somehow that got closed up and all my music was gone. Ugh. Give me... You know, Britt, you were talking about Thousand Islands dressing. Mm-hmm. There is nothing I enjoy more than a good Reuben with all that nice sauerkraut and dipping it in the Thousand Island with the nice toasted rye bread. That is the good stuff, yeah. Yeah, yeah. And when I see one, before I walk away from the table, I say to my sandwich, I say...
What do you say to your sandwich?
I'll be back.
You're such a plunker.
It is the good stuff there, yeah? I love this. A good Reuben. Love a Reuben sandwich. I haven't had one in a long time.
I know you normally have one at Cracker Barrel, don't you?
Is that where I get them?
Yeah.
Well, then we better go back there. No, I don't like them assholes. I'm not going there anymore. People... Idiots.
I like the food in Cracker Barrel.
Too expensive.
I can't be doing with the people coming back every 5 minutes. Can I get you anything? Can I get you anything? Do you want a top up? If I want a top up, I'll ask for a top up.
I don't know. That one waitress came over there, that young little girl. She came over there and says, you want a top up? And she just lifted her top up. And I was like, yeah, give me another
one. Exactly. If I wanted a top up, I'd ask for a top up.
I don't mind for a good top up. Now, when I was young and Pop had his 58 Ford retractable hardtop, it was always with the top down.
Believe me, I didn't want the woman's top up. I didn't want any nipples in me soup. You know what I'm saying?
But they were pert little. Anyways, never mind.
Benny says that Arby's has good Reuben's.
Didn't I get one there one time? Because it had the marble toast, I think. Isn't that where I had that?
No, that's Cracker Barrel. They do the one with the marble toast.
No,
they
I
do.
Don't think so. Can't even imagine.
That's where look pirates that. Like to go to eat, Benny. They Eric like to go to Arby's.
That's where Granny goes to. Eric is laughing at my nipple joke.
How do you know she was laughing at you?
What's there's wrong like with a top up?
There's a 20-second delay before they hear it and we speak. So she might have been laughing because I'm so funny. Well, I'm not really funny.
See, I told you right there then. Arby's has marble bread.
Yeah, and see? So does Cracker Barrel.
I know, that's good stuff.
Nothing I had like a
Reuben. I'm not big on Arby's, but, I can't stand them roast beef sandwich thingies, but that was good. That Reuben was pretty good.
I had a gyro at Arby's. Was it Arby's I had one at?
No.
The one called Jack in the Box. I had a gyro at Jack in the Box, and... it's like a really tidy and neat kebab, you know. As a Brit, you want your kebab in a right disgusting-looking mess, you know. You scrape off all the turkey into your, or lamb. It's mostly lamb, but I like it turkey. And you scrape it all off into your kebab pita bread. And then you put loads of salad in, put your mayo in there. And you squash the big bugger together and nom nom nom.
I used
but
to have
those,
some good...
those gyros that they do, they're just all neat.
Oh, I used to have those in Chicago at this little truck stand. It would stop outside of Chicago about 20 miles. It's like there's this road where it's like out in the middle of nowhere. You wouldn't think
like, no,
so.
No, that was
Chicago,
it. She was laughing at your nipples.
This guy was always parked on the side of the road, man. I always go in there and he always made the best gyros in the world. Like, yeah.
It's kind of crazy because I went all my life not really liking kebabs in the UK. And as soon as I got to America, I was like, oh, I am gagging for a kebab. I can't stand all this food over here. And I don't even like kebabs. So we went for a gyro and it's close enough.
Even Erica knows there's nothing wrong with a pert little nipple once in a while.
Like I say, I don't want it in my Cracker Barrel, Cracker Barrel soup.
Now she says they use cucumber dressing on their pert nipples. Well, that's interesting.
She's talking about in the gyros.
No.
She probably means in the Reuben things. Oh, and Randy likes that cucumber dressing, don't you, baby?
I do, actually.
He loves to lick
what
it
I like
nipples.
Is the cucumber slices in the white sauce. I forget what you call that, but that's good, too. That's pretty good stuff. But then I burp up the cucumbers for about a week. It's like eating hot dogs. You have to have them twice a day. You know, you eat them at lunch, and then, like, at, before dinner, you start burping up the hot dogs. You taste them all over again. Ugh, I know.
Yeah. We never got to do our video, by the way. We promised you guys a video this week, and we never did it. You know, we spent all afternoon messing around with it. And
well,
we
did do it, kind of.
Yeah, we spent 10 minutes last week on the show talking about how it's so important to have good lighting while using a green screen.
I know.
And we did the whole video, loaded it all up into the program, went to remove the green screen, and it removed half our heads. So and we ended up with silver teeth. And
so don't listen to anything we say.
And half our heads, so don't listen to anything that we say. But it's true, though, Benny, if you've not got the right lighting, then you are screwed when it comes to that. So we still need to do that song.
And I'm behind on my video pick of the week. I didn't get it
done. Yeah, Randy's
yet, so
not done
do
a video
tomorrow.
Pick. No.
I know. I do one every week, and I got it all picked out and all that, but just...
Get it.
Haven't been feeling good the last couple days. So the headache's been killing me. I know it's the weather's going to change. It's got to be. It says now it's supposed to get cold, and that big front's coming through, and rain, and...
Oh. Thomas said he's going to get you that video for the streak. Because when we do our, we was hoping that we can get it ready in time. I don't know, but when we do our group sing-alongs where we get everybody recording bits of video and singing along and throwing it all in the pile, and then we make a big video out of it. But yeah, the next one we was gonna do was the "Don't Look Ethel" song, but we can do another one before we start that if you want, Thomas. You know, we said we won't do that one without you because we need to see you running naked around Walmart.
Benny, did you get your green screen yet?
Erica said, so you literally lost your heads with that one.
See, Brenda said her sinus has been acting up, so it's a Yankee thing, I guess, man.
I wondered whether it was sugar, because normally Randy will have donuts and little bits of sugary stuff throughout the day, but he's had nothing all day like that. So I wondered whether it was that. I certainly
I know,
get
I've
headaches
had, like,
when I don't.
Two cigarettes a day for the last 3 days, and no sugar, and I'm out of blood pressure pills, and the end is near. Oh, we're doomed. But anyways,
so we are going to work on that video. Maybe you can play them the song that we was going to do for the video, so at least they know the song that we're working on. This is totally 100% me and Randy. You know, we literally lock horns. There is no two ways about it.
And I guess if you like, we can do that. Let me find it here. I gotta go over here, I guess. Yankee. Anything. There it is.
So this is us singing it. We just have to do a video. And we sung it about 2 years ago. And we thought, we're going to do a video for that one day. And we was adamant we was going to do a video. But it all messed up.
Well, let's do this because I got these loaded up. And then we'll come back and we'll play that one. And you guys can see the video we're going to work on. And then you can go look up the actual video. Or maybe Don will stick the link in there and you can see where we get it from if you're not familiar with it. Anyways.
Or if you guys want to spend the next 5 minutes guessing what it was from the film Annie Get Your Guns. So do you know what song it is? Answers on a postcard.
All right. Hit it.
I want to rock!
I want some...
She's the guy. She's that bitch.
That dress sure had me fooled. For a minute there, I thought you were going to be a lady. Going to be a pleasure to give you a lesson in marksmanship.
You couldn't give a lesson in long-distance spitting. Anything you can do, I can do better. I can do anything better than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Anything you can be, I can be greater. Sooner or later, I'm greater than you.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am. Yes, I am. I can shoot a partridge with a single cartridge.
I can get a sparrow with a bow and arrow.
I can live on bread and cheese.
And only on that?
Yes.
So can a rat.
Any note you can reach, I can go higher.
I can sing anything higher than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Anything you can buy, I can buy buy cheaper. I can buy anything cheaper than you.
50 cents?
40 cents?
30 cents?
20 cents?
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Anything you can say, I can say softer.
I can say anything softer than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
I can drink my liquor faster than a flicker.
I can do it quicker. I can get even sicker.
I can open any safe
without being caught?
Sure.
That's what I thought, you crook.
Any note you can hold, I can hold longer.
I can hold any note longer than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Yes, you can.
What you wear, I'd look better than you.
In my coat?
In your vest?
In my shoes?
In your hat?
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Anything you can say faster.
I can say anything faster than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
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 No, you can't. Yes, I can. Can't. I can jump a hurdle.
I can wear a girdle.
I can knit a sweater.
I can feel it better.
I can do most anything.
Can you bake a pie?
No.
Neither can I.
Any note you can sing, I can sing sweeter.
I can sing anything sweeter than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
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 No.
For Mr. Checo. Yankee and the Brit Friday night. Hell yeah, that's the night to be anywhere, actually. Gotta love a Friday. RTM Radio Network. Brand new tune here from Benny Pitzinger. And then we're gonna have a threesome with Erica.
Threesome?
We are. We have three songs from Erica.
I nearly had a threesome once. I just needed two other people, and I was there. I was banging away. I know. I'm talking rubbish. Just play the bloody song.
Benny
Dan
Pitzinger.
Conley! Quick sailor to Dan Conley.
Dan Conley.
Dan Conley.
Okay, we're going to play that too.
No.
The Dan
no.
Conley song. Yes.
I think we should sing it for him and record it so that we never have to hear
we'll
those gaggy voices in that song. I
we'll
hate the gaggy
it.
Voices.
Then we'll have to play it. Sit back and enjoy the music. Here's Benny and Lightning in the Water.
Lightning Hawkins hauled his moonshine in a flathead Ford V8. They said it was the fastest car in all the southern states. 100-gallon tank where the back seat would have been. Full of liquor smooth enough to make a Baptist deacon sin. When you see that smoke rising for the pines on Stony Hill, you know that Lightning Hopkins is firing up his still. Lock up your dogs and children, there's thunder on the road. Time for Lightning Hopkins to haul another load. The sheriff sat waiting by the bridge across this foggy lake. He heard the V8 coming from a couple miles away. Called out to his deputy, hurry up, he's coming fast. Pulled out and blocked the roadway so Lightning couldn't pass. Now he likely saw the blockade when he rounded Snitch's curve. Lightning barreled straight ahead, They never break the swerve. Straight into the roadblock. Full lightning, he did crash. Rolled several times before he jumped the rail and landed with a splash. But when you see that smoke rising over the pines on Stone Hill, you know that Lightning Hawkins is firing up his still. Lock up your dogs and children, there's thunder on the road. Time for Lightning Hawkins to haul another load. Jimbo brought his wrecker down and shined his big old lights. The rescue squad all gathered there and they began to dive. But all they found were pieces of Lightning's Ford V8. And whatever's left of Lightning still sleeps under the foggy lake. Well, a sheriff wrote a message on what's left of Lightning's hood. And propped it on the bridge rail for all to read who could. It said, no need in fishing, cause they're all too drunk to bite. There's lightning in the water of Foggy Lake tonight. When you see that smoke rising, hold the pines on Stony Hill. You know that Lightning Hawkins was firing up his still. Lock up your dogs and children, cause there's thunder on the road. Time for Lightning Hawkins to haul another load. Last night, Lightning Hawkins, he hauled his final load. Old Lightning Hawkins.
Old Lightning Hawkins, Yankee and a Brit Friday night. Getting her done, Benny, getting her done. Okay, now, where was I? Somewhere
very
between
good
here and there.
Where was you? Where is my microphone?
Right here. Stop.
There you
all the time.
Go.
I get tired of hearing.
See how easy that is.
All right.
Ah. Ha, ha, ha. Erica says that she can't wait to hang out with us all next Sunday. She's not right, is she? She's
Why,
really
next
not
Sunday?
Right. She's joining us on the Yankee and the Brit show. I wish you'd pay attention.
I'm not doing a show next Sunday.
Yes, we are.
I'm not doing one.
Yes, we are.
I refuse.
Yes, you are. Yes, you are.
No,
yes,
I'm not.
Yes, you are.
Yes, Benny, it is a little different from you, I must say.
It's certainly not your, not what I expected.
No, me neither. Be honest.
I like it,
be
but
honest.
I'm just not sure whether it's Benny.
It's not.
It's not.
No, I can't. I am not one to keep my mouth shut. I would rather.
Well, we can gather that.
I was going to say something in private to him, but, you know, since you keep bringing it up because you don't have any.
You keeping your mouth short, there's more chance of selling rocking or shit to the Arabs.
But no, it's just not Benny. That's not. No, I don't think it's because you're stretching. It's. First thing. Okay, here we go. Because it doesn't matter. I trust you're a friend and you should be able to understand. And understand that I only say it from what I know. What I hear, but it seems like you're in a hurry. That was the first thing I said to Don. I said, sounds like he's in a hurry. Why is he in such a hurry? Is it, you know, I just wasn't sure if you were just trying to crank out a song or if you were just trying something different. I couldn't decide on that, but yeah, it sounded like you're in a hurry, so I just it's not you, that's for sure. It's not the Benny we know and love, that's for sure. But there, it's out now.
Have you said everything you wanted to say?
Yeah, I just
yeah, it's
honest,
just, it's just
you
not,
know.
It's just, it's not,
just
Benny.
Not Benny. It's great stuff. I mean, it's a cool tune. That's not that I don't like it.
Us as Benny Pitzinger, lovers, supporters, you know, the third person in your marriage and all that, the Yankee and the Brit show say it is not a Benny song. Other than that, it's brilliant, isn't
he
it?
He said that's what Steve Owen said.
Yeah. It is a good. It is a good song. It's just not Benny.
No, it was. All, it's a cool tune. Don't get me wrong. I like it, but it's just not your style, man. It's like it's too fast. Like, you know, like I said, it just sounds like you're in a hurry to get it done. And it's like, no, slow down and be Benny. Be He's a storyteller. That's what makes you so cool.
Yes.
Anyways, time for that threesome with Erica. Let's go over here and do this.
Threesome with Erica Foltz right here on the Yankee and the Brit Show.
I know, and we have never
I am just two more people away from getting my threesome.
We have never had a threesome with anyone, so this is our first time, so we will try to be gentle.
Apart from Steve Hickman. Steve Hickman come in bed with us. Remember that night? That was a bit creepy, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah. Oh, we need to play some Steve,
we
too.
Do need to play
That's
some Steve.
That's always good music. All right, let's
You're
move on.
You're neglecting us of our Steve.
This is Erica Foltz. She's in the chat. Great lady. Like I've said before, you can come in the chat with the Yankee and the Brit Show and talk to these artists and hang out with them and just laugh and have a good time. And, you know, share the page and tell people that. Tell your fans and your followers. You know, when we make these posters and things, a lot of people don't share them. I don't understand that you want to promote yourselves. And this is not directed at you, Erica, or Benny, or anybody else. This is just overall, anybody that has heard me rant before. But you got to share these things. That's why we make them. We tried to help you. We make these, and you have to share them with your followers and say, look, I'm going to be on this show, you know. Because I see it all the time for other radio stations. Constantly people saying, I'm going to be on this show, or listen to this radio show, or do this or that radio show. But I never see anything about us. And it's like, you know what? You're going to be on this show. We are helping you. We're giving you a place to put your music. But you need to tell your fans, you know, that they can come here and talk with you and listen to you sing and get to know your music. And, yeah, we don't do the voting thing. We don't do any of that crap that the other stations do. We don't get into drama. We don't fight and argue. We don't do politics or religion. A little touch here and there, but nothing to get excited about. We don't get into all that crap. We don't have commercials. We are here for the music. We are here for you. You have to share it to let people know you're here. This is why we do this. So please, let people know who you are, where you are, and what's going on. Because I think it's pretty damn cool to be able to go to a radio show and be able to talk to the people that make the music. You know, whether it's unknown music or, you know, Garth Brooks, for God's sake, or anybody famous. It doesn't matter. You know, it would be cool to go in there
and
talk to
Erica
people.
In our chat room has performed with Leanne Rimes on stage. I mean, how cool is that? You guys get to chat to her.
Some of these people just, you know, and I'm not talking about anybody that's been on this show ever. Not a one of them. But there are artists out there that just think they're too damn cool to come to the little lower class places and just chit-chat and gab and, you know, I don't know what they're afraid of. We had somebody that was supposed to come on the show one time, never heard another word from them. So, you know, my guess is they listened to the show, they didn't like what they heard, and disappeared. And that's fine. That's their choice. We don't care. No skin off my nose. But it's just the idea. It's like there are people like that. It's like, how could you possibly think you are above and beyond the people that make you who you are? But they do that. I don't want you guys to be that way. We have some awesome people in here, some of the best friggin' artists. You guys are the nicest people we've ever known, and we are not people.
We are really not people.
But where can you go and sit
Randy's
and chat with
a people?
Where can you go and sit? Where can I go? Where could we go? And if somebody ever says one day, that Erica Foltz, she is awesome. Where can we go and say, yeah, we're friends with her. We've talked to her 100,000 times. You know, who else can do that? Not many people.
Yeah, exactly.
Only the people in this chat. You know, I bet you can't do that at other radio stations or the radio shows. You can. Some of them have a chat room, but they sure as hell aren't, from what I see, not very sociable, if you will. I've read some pretty nasty reviews on a lot of other radio shows, you know. I do go around and listen to them and see what they're doing and things. And, you know, I think that's one reason Donna and I don't get involved in all that stuff. All that friggin' drama and fighting and arguing.
I know some people have been inviting us to other radio show pages. And we take one look at the pages and we see some of the drama going off. And we're just like, we do our show. We log on and we log off and then we go home. Oh, we're already home, but
you know, and no offense to anybody that's done it, but why would I want to join another radio show? Why would I want to be in their chat or go in there? And they think you're trolling when you do that. If we go in there, you know, Harry Burke is and Sammo, and Sammo's off on his own now doing, he's got his own little radio station going in Florida. He's really moving around. I think it's pretty cool. Good luck for him and cool for Sammo. But Harry Burke is like the only show we can go into, really, and just chit-chat. Because he knows. He's friends with Donna. He's been friends with Donna for years. So he knows there's no threat. But you go into these other places, man, they'll bash you. They'll talk about you behind your back. They'll beat you up. you know, and it's like, you don't even know what you're talking about. They just make shit up so they can slam you because they're the coolest. We don't want you in here, you know. They think you're trolling, trying to get people to leave them and come to us, and I would never, ever say that. I don't want anybody coming to our show unless you want to be here. And if you come in and you don't like it and you leave, well, no skin off my nose again. We're just tickled to death to have you stop by for a few minutes. But we're not doing that drama shit, you know. And I don't want to listen to other radio stations, per se, you know,
as a fan.
I don't want to be in their chat room. I don't want to be a faithful follower. I like to listen to some of them, see what they got going on. You know, that's me as the DJ from forever, just knowing, trying to understand what everybody else is doing. But what everybody else does, I don't want to do it because I don't like the way they do it, and I don't want to be like them, so we don't do anything. Does that make any sense? You know, and like me, I'm honest as the day is long, and sometimes that's to a fault, but, you know, you'll never get no bullshit out of me. I'll tell you exactly how it is, and if you don't like it, you know. Just like Benny, you know, he asked about the song. I was going to say something to him privately, but since you brought it up and it was in the open, well, okay, whatever. But, you know, and that's just out of respect for who he is and, you know, as a musician. It's like, you know what, why did you do that song is what I was going to say, but now he knows, but I was honest. You know, and I think regardless of how it feels when somebody tells you honestly something, I don't like a lot of things I hear people tell me honestly.
But it's not like you're saying...
But it's okay because it's good for you in the end.
It's not like you're saying that his song sucks, you know. It's not like you sat there bitching
it doesn't suck. It's just not Benny. It's not his
style. His song is a good song. So, yeah, I'm glad that we can just be all honest with each other in the chat. And just
I keep bringing this up every once in a while. It's just if, you know, anybody's sitting back that's just listening and doesn't get in the chat or anything and you're thinking about coming in here, if you don't like what we do or who we are or what we're about, don't waste my time. Don't waste your time. Go listen to the gossip and the rumors and the bullshit if that's what you want. You won't find it here. You might hear me whine a little bit. Maybe a good
rant. A little bit?
And 81 Fs. Ask Johnny. He knows. He counts them. Someday I'll play that again when I...
Yeah, Randy said the F word 81 times in the space of like 6 minutes. And somebody in our chat room counted. But we've cut down on all the swearing. I don't like to hear myself swear.
What does this mean, by Felicia?
Oh, you know when there's like drama queens and they're like, I'm going. You know, when they get all Marty.
Oh, another one of those sayings. Okay. I've heard people use different names over the years, and it's like, you know, I can't remember the one that was going around a few years ago, but I get it. Okay. Well, you know, Benny, that's always, you know, you say you find it hard for someone to be honest with you about your music. Well, that's, like I said, one of my problems is being honest to a fault. Because I tell people, you know, that's why I make a lousy boss and a lousy manager and why I never could stay managing a shop like I did or anything. Like I had the opportunity a couple times and I just couldn't do it because I was telling people, look, that's not how you do it. You know, I don't want you to do it my way, but let me show you my way and then you learn from my way and then you learn how to do it your way, my way, if that makes any sense whatsoever. You know, here's how it should be done. Now you go learn how to do it my way. Then as you go on, you can learn how to do it your way, blah, blah, blah. People don't like that. A lot of people don't like that. Creative people hate that. I'll do it my way. I'm the same way. Don't tell me how to do something. I may screw it up a time or two, but I'll get it right. And then I'll do it my way. But either way, you know, it's... people don't like honesty sometimes, you know. They do later on when they have time to think about it, after it sinks in. But in the beginning, they hate it. You know, there's been so many people that get pissed off at me because I tell it like it is, you know.
And, I don't always tell people when I don't like their songs or if it just doesn't feel right to me, because, you know, it might not be my cup of tea, but it might be everybody else's cup of tea. You know, there's a lot of things me and Randy look at things and I'm like, that's ugly.
Yeah, cars, I got it, Erica.
Cars, for example, you know, Randy will say, that car is badass. And I'm like, it's ugly. You know, everybody's tastes are different. So I don't sit there and go, well, I didn't like your song. You know, I can appreciate the song for what it is. It's a really good song. You know, the lyrics are great, but it's just not Benny, or it's just not my thing. I don't know. It's one or the other, isn't it?
But Benny's the kind of guy I just feel comfortable talking with.
Yeah.
Telling him, you know, dude, come on, man. That ain't you. What are you doing? But most people, yeah, like you, I would never tell everybody if their music sucks or not. You know, I wouldn't play it that much, but I will give everybody the chance. I always play everybody's music somehow, some way we get it in. Even, you know, we have 3 days every other weekend to do that. So there's a lot of songs I play that I don't care for them, but I play them because that's what I said I would do. We are here to help people. It doesn't matter whether you're good or bad. We want to play your music, and we want you to be heard. And you can hear yourself, and your friends can hear you, provided you share us with other people. And then you all can decide, you know. Some people are meant to be singers, some aren't. Donna yeah, this, and I know we're not professional singers,
this is
but
what
we do it for fun.
This is one thing we don't do is... You know, on I don't know whether you guys notice on the Yankee and the Brit Facebook page, sometimes we just pull posts down because there's certain people, you know, you guys, you know, Erica, she gets involved with us, she gets involved with the show, she talks to us, and even if she doesn't come and talk to us in the chat room, she'll say hello or she'll comment or she'll reply to my posts or I'll comment on her stuff and she'll reply, you know. She's not rude. But there's certain people that go on our radio page, they will just dump their link and they will just go like they're just dumping on our page and 20 other pages. And then when people comment and say, hey, this is a really good song, they don't even reply to them, you know, and I just think that's rude. So there's certain people that, you know, if we see that they're not responding to the people that are taking the time to listen to the music and comment on their stuff, then we just bump them off the page, you know, we don't do it like straight away, but if they constantly do that, you know, just ignore people, then it makes you think they're just one of those people that just dump the link here, there and everywhere and they don't really care so long as it's out there.
It's like a lovely cup of tea.
Exactly.
Yes, it's like a lovely cup of tea.
Just not doing the drama, not doing the bullshit. I'm just here for the music. That's the only thing I'm here for.
Benny said, my wife says all my songs are beginning to sound alike. I guess I showed her.
I know,
you showed me too,
that's
Benny.
That's what I was
Pitsinger.
Laughing about. All right, let's do the Erica thing over here. I want to have a threesome with her, so let's do it. Here's Erica Faltz, kicking it off with Tin Man, then Crazy, and then, of course, her fabulous Walking After Midnight.
Yankee time for a fag. I'm smoking a fag, Thomas says. I am smoking a fag.
I forgot all about that.
I know, we need Stacey in here for that kind of thing.
I know, right? I don't even know where it is.
Look at Thomas, he sent a cup of tea song by Don Williams
I
to
know,
play.
That's why I just played and you a clip, figure it out.
And at some point tonight, you must play the cup of tea song by the Kinks. You know the one? Have a cup of tea. That one?
Oh, yeah.
Have a cup of tea.
I was just trying to find... You know, you're supposed to keep talking like I'm not doing anything over here.
No, you're not. You just sat there
you
with your dick
talk
in your hand.
About what
as
I'm doing.
Always.
Screw shit all the fuck up.
I am smoking a fag.
Here's Erica Faltz with the Yankee and the Brit Friday night.
One drives the train, the other has the caboose. It's the Yankee and the Brit.
All aboard!
Tin Man. Makes me think of the Cars. She's the dangerous type. Guy Paul Tabal and Dangerous Strangers with the
yes,
Yankee and the Brit.
Guy
brand
Paul.
New right there for us.
Every yeah, day we are getting awesome music in our email.
That's what makes us so cool.
And you haven't played Love Shack for Niecy yet. Jeez,
I haven't.
Her head will go all wobbly and
imagine
fall off.
That. Oh, the poor thing.
Are you there, Niecy? Randy's about to hit that play button.
If she's not, everybody else is going to have fun and you're not.
You're all over the road with Randy and Donna Bradley. And quit tailgating.
Niecy!
Niecy!
Better get it on, girl.
If you see a faded sign at the side of the road that says 15 miles to the
Love Shack! Love Shack, yeah. I'm heading down the Atlanta Highway. Looking for a love getaway. Headed for a love getaway.
I got me a as big as a whale, and we're heading on down to the Love Shack. I got me a Chrysler, and it seats about 20. So come on and bring your jukebox money.
The Love Shack is a little old place where we can get together. Love Shack, baby.
Love Shack, baby.
Love Shack, baby. Love Shack.
kissing and a loving. Well, the next to nothing, cause it's hard as an elephant. The whole shape she needs. The whole shape she needs. The whole shape she needs. When everybody's moving around and around and around. Just to get down.
Everybody's moving, everybody's moving, baby.
Funky little shack, funky little shack. I hopped in my Chrysler, it's as big as a whale, and it's about to set sail. Woo! Got me a call, it seats about 20. So come on and bring your jukebox money.
The Love Shack is a little old place where we can get together. Love Shack, baby.
A Love Shack, baby.
Love Shack, better Love Shack. Love Shack, better Love Shack. Love Shack.
Times can we sing that?
I know, I just said she needs to choose a new song of ours because I'm sick of hearing it.
But a request is a request. Anyways, I want to play a tune for y'all that my wife sang for me. She's so hot.
So I've got to agree with that one.
It's my Brit over here singing Chasing Cars on the Yankee and the Brit Show Friday night. Hello, Friday.
We're live in 3, 2, 1. Hit it!
Feel.
My wife. Get her done, baby. Get her done.
You're listening to the Yankee and the Brit on the RTM radio network. Don't make me say it again.
CKLW, the Motor City.
The old man told his story about the years gone by, how he played his horn down in New Orleans and some old dingy dive.
I knew them all back then, he said, as he reached out for his horn.
He closed his eyes and wet his lips, and then the blues were born. Tears came from his eyes. He stopped and reminisced a bit, and then he gave a sigh. He said,
"You know, I almost made it,
but that was before your time. Dixieland, Ho-Ho Blues, Scatman Jack and Wine."
Slapped his knee and gave a grin.
It sure was good back then. Reaching for his home on the floor.
Placed it in an old tote sack.
that hung across his back. He said goodbye and shuffled out the door. Enthused by what it told me, I never got his name. So I called the waitress over and started to explain. A tired old man, his tarnished horn, memories of years gone by. How he played his horn, reminisced, smiled with tears in his eyes. She said, "You are mistaken. There's been no one but you. But I know who you're talking about. I used to know him too. You'll find him down on Mason Street, in the back of an old churchyard. A stone that reads, 'Let's do this.' I tried, but it sure was hard." Slapped his knee and gave a grin. It sure was good back then. Reaching for his horn on the floor. Placed it in an old tote sack that hung across his back. He said goodbye and shuffled out the door. He said goodbye and shuffled out the door.
Grant Daniels with Country Soul. Enjoy.
I crave those songs about hugging and kissing, songs about life and love that's missing. Play them fast or play them slow, cause I got country in my soul. Love those songs for losing and winning, songs about fate and people grinning. Play those songs right off the chart, cause I've got country in my heart. Steel guitar, it sounds just right. Fiddle's playing hot tonight. Guitar players drumming and picking. Bass and drums keep it all kicking. Clap your hands and stomp the boots if you have country in your boots. Grab your hat and wave it high. You're a country kind of guy. Randy Travis and George Strait are the ones that sound so great. Merle, Willie, Conway, too, inspire me to sing for you. Alan Jackson, Johnny Cash, have a lot of country class. Waylon Jennings, Jim and Hank, are the guys I'd like to thank. Clap your hands and stomp your feet. If you love that country beat. So stand up, girls, give us a yell. If you're a country kind of gal. Steel guitar, it sounds just right. Fiddle's playing hot tonight. Guitar players drumming and picking. Bass and drums keep it all kicking. Clap your hands and stomp your boots. Now you have country in your roots. Your hat and wave it high. Now you're a country kind of guy. you're a country kind of gal.
Hey friends, this is Erica K. Foltz, right here on the Yankee and Brit Show.
You gotta have boobs if you want to impress tycoons and boobs. You need boobs to fill out a sweater. You need two, but three might be better. That's one in the back for dancing. Do, 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 do. You gotta be stacked. Hey, you gotta be grouped, individually packed. For with boobs you can start a romance off. Make a man stand right up and take his hat off. I know it doesn't rhyme, Ducky, but it does keep me legitimate. To make a ball for the earth and the mother, even a cow has to show her a dish. You gotta have boobs, B-O-O-B-S. Some push them up and some stick them out, and some keep them flapping in the breeze. Some tie them down, because if they don't, they would hang down to their knees. Just you tease. You gotta have boobies if you want men to offer diamonds and rubies. Why, even a tennis player would knock his balls out over the net for a chick who fills each cup until she falls out. Big, small, or medium, more oversized. They've all got that flavor and it's homogenized. You gotta have boobs, B-O-O-B-S. Now some have enough and some have too much, and some like me could stand a whole lot more. Some are like watermelons, and some are like grapes, and some are like knobs upon the door. Watch your score. You gotta be filled. Two fried eggs will never grab him like grapefruits will, and they're both breakfast foods. But listen, girls, don't try to fool your lover. Remember, he can go to Gucci if he wants rubber. Some men are like men, and some are behind men. But if he's a boobs man, even a blind man will find him. You gotta have boobs, B-O-O-B-S. You think it's easy to write songs like this? Lots of research. Just think, if all us girls have boobies with fluorination, we could take the cavities out of the whole damn nation. A nibble a day keeps the dentist away. Out cockers like big knockers. This goes over great in Derby. You gotta have boobs or be kind to your flat-chested friends. Tomorrow she may be bigger than you are. You start out with a cup and wind up with eco. Silicone's a good.
Donna and boobs.
By request, for our good friend DeBrod. And that's DeBrod that holds the tits. She is listening via the Facebook today.
Hi, Carol.
So DeBrod and the Brat are tuned in. These are all talking about boobies in the chat room. Benny says he wishes he didn't have boobs.
You got moobs, buddy. Man boobs. Moobs, you gotta have moobs if you want to be a man who dresses like a girl. I guess I don't friggin' know.
Betty says, thank you, Donna, you are more than kind. It's very true, though. I just absolutely love your music. I love your writing and I love your music. Very, very cool.
Mm-hmm.
Randy's guzzling down something.
Oh,
so
my God.
If he's a little bit rude good. Over there,
oh,
you know why.
Sorry. I got to eat, you know.
The brat in the chat says that she still has her shirt. Mm. And the brat hat.
And the brat hat. I'm sorry. I found a little bit of Nestle's quick.
Nesquik.
No high fructose corn syrup, chocolate syrup in the refrigerator. And there wasn't much left, so I poured some milk into the jug and I...
The brat wants to know, or should I say, it's me wants to know how Alfred is doing. Alfred, come over here and say hello to the brat. You've not even said hello to her.
I'm sleeping.
I don't care if you're sleeping. Come and say hello to
well,
the brat.
She's, sleep a little
she's
bit.
Come all the way over to the chat room. Now come all and say
right,
hello.
All right, I'm coming. Hello. Hi, Carol. How are you?
Yeah, Carol Durham's here. Just have you noticed Carol Durham comes in just as Alfred's making a load of noise?
Isn't amazing?
Yeah.
Well, she's my girl.
Well, since when do you have a girl?
Well, since Frenchie left town.
What? Where'd Frenchie go?
I don't know. She got in the back of a U-Haul truck and haven't seen her since.
Oh, all right. Well, then she's gone.
So how is Alfred tonight? I see you've been learning to play your guitar this week.
No, where do you come up with this stuff?
Well, what was you doing then if you wasn't trying to learn how to play a guitar?
He wasn't learning how to play it.
Alfred was racing around the house like you do as...
I was just trying it on for a fit. I wanted to see if I could hold it, but I'm left pawed.
You're left pawed. He was going around the house, let me tell you, our radio dog was going around the house with a sweeping brush and pretending to be Elvis Presley. He even did the Elvis Presley lip. And,
I got the lip down. That's easy to do. Thank you. Thank you very much. See how that looks?
You're nuts.
Was you all shook up, Alfred?
No, but I had some suspicious thighs.
What? Can you say that again?
Suspicious thighs.
Never mind.
I wish the dog would have swept up while he was racing around with
you know the song.
Suspicious thighs.
Suspicious thighs.
Yeah, that's it. Okay. All I hear is you going, da, 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 da. Well, you learn to speak better.
Look, I said hello to Carol, so now I can go, right?
Yeah. So, hey, you've not said hello to It's Me in the chat room.
Hello, me.
You just said hello to yourself, dog. You're supposed to say hello to It's Me.
It is me. Who else is it if it's not me?
No, it's me.
What are you talking about, it's me? Of course it's me.
Never mind. What is this, like a who's on first?
No, who's on second?
Don't even start.
I did warn it's me in the chat room that if you call yourself it's me, then when people go to talk to you, then they're going to have trouble.
But I am calling me. I don't understand. It's me. Doesn't get any easier than that, Mom.
Yes. I understand what you're saying, buddy, but you're not getting it.
What is not to get about? It's not me, it's me.
Never mind.
So, Alfred, what song did you learn this week while you was learning that guitar?
Hound Dog.
Hound Dog? You're not funny.
I told you I was curling my lip.
Now we know why.
So do our listeners, because they're all here to listen to you tonight, do they get a little bit of a sample of how the song sounds?
No, I only know one word.
Well, come on, let's hear it.
Oh, jeez.
Alfred. You spent all that time skidding around the house with underpants on your head and a guitar as a sweeping brush.
Well, that's just the way it goes.
You nutbag.
I swear that dog has so much attitude.
Well, I can't sing I Ain't Nothing But a Hound Dog because I'm not. What great dang.
Next time, I'm going to record the dog when he is singing randomly in the house. And then I'm going to play it on the show and show you guys that that our dog really
hey,
does
hey,
sing.
Hey, we're not doing that Red Solo Cup thing again, are we?
Go on, sing it.
Do, 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 do. Yeah, I know that part.
Jeez. Well, you do know that one pretty good, don't you? You did it enough times. How many takes was there, like 40 for him to get that right?
Yeah, like 40 takes.
No, it was only 38.
And lots and lots and lots of chews, doggy chews.
38, 40, what's the difference?
Two.
Oh, you can count two now, okay. Little shit. All right.
So, So how did the French poodle end up in the back of the UPS van?
I don't know, Mom. I just said I saw a gate. I didn't say UPS, I said U-Haul.
U-Haul?
Don't you listen?
No.
No, she doesn't. Are you kidding? Ask me if she listens.
Well, no, she doesn't.
Don't tell me anything new.
I know. He's always secretive about that poop.
Now, can I go back
road.
To sleep?
Yes, you could go back to sleep.
Thank you, Mom.
We might even let you cock your leg up against the side of the tree later.
Goodbye, Alfred. Bye, Pop.
Bye.
Bye, Carol.
See, he never says bye-bye to me. That dog.
Bye to me.
Oh, jeez.
Attitude on that boy.
That's why I don't ask him to come over.
Alfred the radio dog, everybody.
All right, then. Jolly good.
Good night, Erica.
Cheerio. Thanks for the threesome. It was a lot of fun. Put nipples and all, you know. All right.
Night, Erica.
He saw that, believe it or not. You know how dogs have such good night vision. You can
oh,
see
yeah. That dog is so selective. Sometimes it's like, I can't see it. But, oh, yeah, he can read. He can sing. He can
uh-huh.
Talk.
All right, so moving right along. What time is it? Ooh, we've got lots of time, lots of music. Hey, we got a brand new one here from Scott D. Harris, too. Now, he was just on the show with us, wasn't he?
No, he's coming on the show tomorrow.
Well,
it's
the
a good job someone's paying attention.
Who was the hairy guy that was with us?
The hairy guy.
I thought we had a Scott or a Harry or Harris or something.
No, we had Tommy Lee Moffat 2 weeks ago or a week ago.
All right. Well, then
but
Scott
tomorrow
D. Harris
we have
is
Scott
going to be with
D.
us tomorrow.
Oh, tomorrow.
So here's one of his tunes. And right after that, I got a song for you that I did about the Brit.
Well, I was raised in a crazy-ass kind of style. Yeah, my taste in music and women drove my folks half wild. Mom and Pop had a plan for me. It was splitting wood, mowing grass, you see. But I like my music, I like my women wild. Yeah, I like my women just a little on the British side. And they wear their clothes too tight and their cunt hairs dyed. Lipstick and too much rouge. Gets me excited, leaves me feeling confused. And I like my women just a little on the British side. You should have seen the looks on the faces of my dead mom when I showed up at the door with a Brit for my senior prom. They said, well, partner, son, she ain't no kid. That's a British woman in the Dolly Parton wig. I said, I know it, Dad, ain't she cool? That's the bitch I dig. Yeah, I like my women just a little on the British side. When they wear their clothes too tight and their cunt hairs dyed. Too much lipstick and too much douche. Gets me excited, makes me feel confused. And I like my women just a little on the British side. Sweet, I like them when they fought in gold. Yeah, I like them brassy, I like them British and bold. Well, they say that opposites attract, and I sure agree. I want a Brit that's just as trashy as me. Yeah, I like my women just a little on the British side. Side. When they wear their clothes too tight and their cunt hairs dyed. Too much lipstick and too much douche. Gets me excited, leaves me feeling confused. And I like my women just a little on the British side. Yeah, I like my women just a little on the British side.
arrived at a great moment in time.
Yeah! Quitting time!
Who says it's quitting time?
I said it's quitting time.
I'm the foreman. I'm the one says when it's quitting time of terror. Quitting time! Quitting time!
Himself from Cato with the Yankee and a Brit Friday night, Mr. Hill.
Jason Hill is in the chat room, tuned in tonight with his good lady, Renee.
Another one of those great artists I was telling you about that stopped
by. Yes, yes, another fantastic artist tolerated us for the evening last Saturday night.
The dude is way beyond funny.
Yeah, we had
Donna did laugh for the next day when she was playing that back, cleaning it up to post out there. She's like, this guy's killing me.
Especially when I realized he couldn't understand a word I said. I was like, oh my gosh. But I do have to learn to talk slower because I know some of you guys over here cannot understand me. You know, Randy's dad, he like,
what?
Yeah.
What?
He's constantly like, what? What?
Sometimes he literally looks right at me and says, what'd she say?
And like, one particular day I said, Is it because I talk in the wrong pitch? So I'm going, can you hear me now? 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 And he's like,
No.
He says, nope, you just talk too fast. After all that. So it's like, can you hear me now? And he says, yes.
You ever see him when he looks at me when he's talking to you?
Yeah.
When he gives me that glance like, what the fuck is she saying?
He's too cute. Randy's dad is the cutest man in the entire world.
Uh-oh, he's going back to the mud park. You ain't getting my truck. No way.
I know. He was hinting at taking your truck and running it through the mud.
It won't pull itself out of a wet paper bag.
There's videos on my Facebook of of when we got stuck in the mud when we were putting that sign up.
Now, this is one hell of a man right here.
What a man.
Me and Renee actually have a night to ourselves tonight, believe it or not, but it's back on stage tomorrow, and look where he's at.
And he's wasting his time with the Yankee and the Brit show.
If she doesn't wring your little neck. Jason Hill, you get back here in this house now and turn off that Yankee and that Brit. Die. I think some of the mosquitoes from the mud park are in here.
I know. I do happen to blame Jason Hill of the chat room.
I'm going to have to go get one of those cigarettes.
No, you are not.
I am.
No,
driving
no,
me friggin'
no,
bananas.
No, no, ah.
I got your ah. Don't you at me.
At you all I want. I bet Renee has similar troubles with Jason Hill. You know, sometimes you have
Why,
to put your foot down with your bloke, you know.
You smoke, Jason? You don't smoke. You can't sing and smoke. Coffee. That's all that was left.
Really?
And I refuse to make another pot because I'll have to smell it.
Oh, I know. Sometimes,
fresh,
you know, Randy will put on
the fresh
a...
fresh smell of McDonald's coffee.
Yeah, sometimes Randy will put on a pot of coffee about 5 o'clock in the morning. And then he'll come back to bed and we just wake up and the whole house just smells beautiful.
You know, the delay makes it so hard to understand a conversation. Is that yes, he smokes, or yes, Renee gives him problems, or... I just don't know which question it was by now.
Just say yes to all the above.
There you go. Now we'll just bow down to Renee and there'll be no issues. Yeah, I know he smokes. I was surprised. He actually doesn't strike me as a smoker, but... I thought that was pretty well. Speaking of
Set
that, I'm glad you brought that up, Thomas.
Yeah, we have not heard Hickstick. Jason Hill says both. Hickstick, we have not heard no Hickstick tonight. And I
Which
think
one do you want?
We're going to have withdrawal symptoms.
Not long shot.
It's got to be my old favorite, Southern Night.
All right, that's the one we'll do then. All right, then. And Thomas, I did line up your Kiss tune over here, so it is coming up. Just, bear with us here. So anyways.
You burping up your coffee again, husband. Is there anything that you don't do on
this
show?
I shouldn't be drinking it this late, but I've got to go get one of them friggin' cigarettes.
Last week, during Jason
Just
Hill's
one more.
Interview,
That's only three
I had
today.
To sit and cut out all the bits where Randy was chopping his fingernails again. What?
I said if I go get one more, it's only three for today. That's not bad.
It's still one more.
Yeah, but what am I supposed to do? I'm out of everything to eat. I've eaten all the junk food in the house.
I know. What's the worst that could happen? That's a way to make your wife thin.
I'll go outside in the shop and work till friggin' 1 o'clock in the morning, or I fall asleep out there, one or the other.
Yeah, that's how you make your wife thin, is for a guy to quit smoking, eat all the junk food in the house, and the wife can't eat it. He said, Jason Hill in the chat says, if I had my foil hat, I'd call and bother you all.
Just remember what I said, though. Make sure you lean way out over the balcony.
Yeah.
Just a little bit further. Little bit further.
Mr. Bean has the right idea. You know the video where he's trying to set up the TV aerial?
Oh, too far.
And he takes all his clothes off and... oh, what an idiot. I love my Mr. Bean.
He's got his own built-in lightning rod.
Yeah. Oh, husband. You ain't right. If you guys could see what he was doing over here, you would say, give the man a cigarette.
Shut him up. I'm quitting smoking, so I had three yesterday, and I only had two the day before that. So, and two today so far. I'm going to have to go have one more. I'm just never going to forget it. I won't be able to even get over it before I go to bed. Maybe if we get done here and I just go to bed, and maybe we'll see, but it's killing me.
You just ask me if I need to, just let me know if you want me to use that trusty old hammer.
Trusty old hammer?
Yeah.
You mean on the machine?
Yeah, I'll hit you over the head and then you can't think about your fags, can you?
I don't know, Dan. I mean, I feel better already. Yeah, it's funny, man. One day without those things can change how you feel. It really, you know, if you're paying attention. But, you know, and the... all the hacking up the hairballs and stuff is already starting to back off a little bit. But it's tough, man. It is. As long as I'm busy, I'm fine. What the reason I even smoke so damn much is sitting here in front of the computer. I have nothing to friggin' do, and it's killing Donna. And, you know, it's just, like, the more I sit in front of the computer, the worse the habit got. So, you know, like, now in the mornings when it's decent enough outside, when it's below 1,000, I go outside and work on the railroad and stuff, but... You know, like right now, when I'm sitting here, I can't help it. It's driving me friggin' crazy just sitting here. I have to be busy. That's the thing with
you
nature
of
an artist.
You need some plasticine
or
something.
Huh?
You need some plasticine or something.
Some plasticine?
Yeah, to squidge about.
Oh, jeez.
Some of these bowls that my friend sent me? These are called Chinese...
Those are Benoit balls.
They're called stress reliever bowls.
They're Benoit balls.
Can you hear them? Tingly balls. You're supposed to just, roll them in your hands. I end up dropping the bloody things on my foot, and they are very heavy.
Drop them on that keyboard, you'll be sorry.
Yeah, they are very heavy balls.
They're Benoit balls.
Benoit balls.
You know what those are.
It doesn't say Benoit balls on here.
You not talk to Ben very often, no, do you? You need to talk to Ben. He tell you what his ball's for. What's this railroad I keep talking about? How about if I just give you the link and you go look at it? Because I could be here talking about it all night.
And you don't want it getting banging on about his railroad. I mean, about his lovely train. I'm surprised you haven't seen the videos and stuff I posted up. Randy's, he's got a train out there.
I'm building my own railroad.
Yeah, and the squirrels ate all the electrics and stuff and made a right mess inside. And the Texas sun has baked the paint. So he's having to redo the whole thing, the outside of it, and... do all the wiring, and he's been working so hard on it.
There is the link, Mr. Hill, sir, if you care to go through it. And good luck going through it, because I haven't added anything to it in a while, but you can go through the photos on my Facebook page and see all kinds of them in there, videos here and there. But, yeah, it's a work of art in progress, I guess you might say. But I built the engine about, I don't know, how long ago did I start that in Gunner? 5-6 years ago?
Yeah.
And it sat for about 4 years or so. So everything I put into it kind of fell apart. The mice ate a lot of the wiring out of it. They crapped and built nests and all kinds of things in it, and it just sat. And it sat out in the rain, and that didn't do it any good. And little by little, I'm rebuilding it, if you will. But I'm laying track now, and I can actually ride in it, and I can run it now. I have enough track down to make it worth the little ride, but that's where I'm at. That's what I'm talking about, is laying track. I'm laying the track now. A friend of mine gave me all the rail he had at his railroad, so I'm putting it all back together over here, and it's a labor of love, definitely. I love it. Great project. I can't stand the little... And it's nothing against the guys that have the 7 1/4, 7 1/2-inch gauge trains. You ride on those. Mine, I built it so you can ride in it. And I learned a lot as I do it. So the second one will be better, and then on and on and on. But that's basically the railroad that I talk about.
Yes, sir. And it is a beautiful, beautiful red train. It's gorgeous. He's going to be repainting it, aren't you?
Yeah, if you see some of the good pictures of it, it really looks nice when it was all cleaned up and new. It's got two electric scooter motors in it, 750 watts each, so there's just a little over bit of a horse, one horsepower for each motor. But it really goes. It gets up and goes pretty good. Golf cart controller in it to make it go. Pretty wild. A friend of mine put it all together for me. I suck at electric. I know nothing about electrical other than I can wire a house up, but that's about it. I can't do electronics and that kind of thing. Thomas says, I never understood why I smoked at work, because just hang there and burn up. I smoke because I need something to do with my hands. That's why. Sitting here in front of the computer, you know, I may be typing, but most of the time the mouse is in my hand drawing and my left hand is free. So that's where it comes from. And like during the show, I'm doing nothing but, you know, the occasional typing. But other than that, I'm loading music and finding this song and getting that song and doing this and doing that. You know, and Donna does a lot of the chatting. And that's why I smoke when I'm sitting here. I got to be doing something. It drives me nuts. I started smoking when I was driving truck because I sat there for 500, 600, 800 miles a day and did nothing. And it drove me friggin' crazy. And I didn't even start smoking until I was like 32 or something like that.
So you're like, I know what I'll do. I'll start up a smoking habit.
I did. That's what I did. I said, I'm going to make myself
smoke. I think I need
an
addiction.
I started off with cherry cigars and they burnt my mouth and my throat and they were horrible. And I bought a pack of cigarettes one day, and I bought some Marlboro Lights, I think it was, and I was off and running, and Christ, I was up to 5 friggin' packs a day at one point.
I don't think my life's expensive or complicated enough. Let me start smoking.
I know, you know, and you sit around and you say, how in the hell can people afford to, especially people that don't work, how can they afford to go buy a 6-pack of beer every day on their way home from work when they can't pay their bills, and they drive an old beat-up car and all that, but man, some of those habits, that's just the way it is. You find the money.
Exactly. And if you're, you know, like in the UK as well, if you're like classed as an alcoholic, you know, they consider it as an illness and they give it you money towards your booze, you know. They like my nan, you know, they give her money towards her booze because it's considered more of an illness. So
I don't know. I don't think it's an illness like a disease because it can't be cured. You're the only one that can cure it by stopping. I don't find it to be that kind of an illness. I don't think it's a disease per se, but it's just a mind hack. Oh, I hate that word hack. But anyways, like Thomas said, I need to quit, tired of hacking in the mornings. I'll tell you what, 3 days. If you can stop yourself for 3 days, you will notice such a difference that you will not want to smoke anymore. And I'm almost there. 1 or 2 more days, I think I'll be able to go without completely. I'm just quitting cold turkey. You know, 3 a day is pretty damn good if you ask me. You know, and like I said, today's only been 2. I'm really craving that 3rd one. But now that I've been sitting here just running my mouth, I've actually kind of forgotten about it, other than the fact that that's what we're talking about.
So it's not your hands that need something to do, it's your mouth.
Maybe. Well, they're a combination. They work hand in hand, if you will. Without one, I can't have the other.
If I could have known that you could have combated your smoking habit by running your jaw.
You stuffed your fist in it already. Yeah. Shut up.
And that would have kept your hands occupied. You've been trying to pull my fist out.
You smoke that much, Brenda? I don't know. That's, you know, like Jason said, you can't hide money. I don't have any money. That's the thing, you know. I built most of the railroad from gimmies and, you know, spare change, extra money when I have it kind of thing, because, you know, we work for ourselves and the business is nothing like it used to be. It's all slowed down. Of course, you know, the president and everybody says the economy's good. Well, it's good everywhere but here at our house. But I built most of it from scrap. It's a wooden frame, wooden floor. The sheet metal that makes up the body is old signs that I've drug home over the years. It's another reason it took me, you know, a few years to put it together, dragging home the parts. Being able to afford buying a $20 box of screws or whatever, and it's just, it's a labor of love, you know, it's my hobby. I love it. It's one of the few things I've ever started that I actually have finished. I built the railroad, the locomotive shop out here to put the train in, and now it's a nice little workshop. You know, like I got a generator tore apart in there I need to put back together and things. It's a nice little place to work. It sucks in the winter. It's cold as hell. I know there's no heat in there or anything, but it's Ohio style. When I lived in Ohio, it's wooden floor and... But it's what I grew up with. I like all that. I kind of tried to model after my great-grandpa's old blacksmith shop. Just wooden floor, low ceiling kind of things, you know. A lot of hand put together stuff, but it's cool, I think. I don't care what anybody thinks. I like it. But love the railroad. It's called the Texas Northern Railroad, and the main town where it starts is in Donashire. Or is it Donashire?
Donashire.
Which one would you prefer?
Donashire.
Donashire?
That's how you say it where I come from.
All right. Well, you just told me last night it's either Donashire or Donashire.
You don't say Derbyshire where I come from.
I didn't say Derbyshire. I said Donna.
Yes, I know, but I'm saying, yeah, but I'm referring to where that kind of comes from.
Well, why did we have this big long conversation last night that either way was probably okay, Donashire or Donashire?
Oh, I know, because I was just winding you up, you know, pulling on your piss
pants. You know, how am I supposed to learn anything if you friggin' lie to me, you tramp?
Trying to teach Randy the English language and I'm just teaching him a load of rubbish.
You're a jerk. All right, good night, Mr. Hill. And good night, Mrs.
Jason.
Hill.
Good night, Renee.
Pip, pip, chitty-o. Off you go.
They're off to see a
soldier on, then.
Film.
Very good. They love horror movies.
Yes. We are getting into films.
We watch a few good
much.
Horror movies once in a while.
We watched a sweet one last night called The Christmas Dragon.
Yeah, it was all right.
I find it quite sweet.
If you're looking for some decent free movies, you want to go to Redbox.
Redbox.com.
Most of them are HD.
It's not Redbox.com. It is, let me tell
most
you,
most of them
are
in HD. They're good movies. A lot of good ones in there. They're not too far behind the times with a lot of movies either.
Yeah, they load up some really, really good stuff. It's called www.watchonline.red. And there's a little search bar. There's, you know, you can search for stuff like from a few years
throw
ago,
that
different
link in
genres.
Real quick.
Yeah.
It's
and every day along the left hand side of the page, they always update the films. So when we go on there to watch a film, we'll look down the left hand side and see.
They got some X-rated ones in there too.
Yeah,
they got one called
Shark.
They got
Dick.
One called Shark Dick. You gotta look at it. We couldn't stand watching it even. It was stupid as could be. But
I think if you click on, I think it's an adult section, or I can't remember what it's called. I think it's adult section. But yeah, there's some really, really stupid films in there.
Oh my god! But the other movies. Oh, I watched the Avengers in there, Godzilla, Dark Knight, quite a few
Incredible
good movies,
Hulk.
You know.
We have watched so many.
But I'm not one of those ones, and I don't think Don is either. I'm not one of those ones who's going to pay $50 to go to the theater and see a movie tonight because it's the brand new showing of it. I don't give a shit if I watch it 3 years later. You know, I can watch it. We go on YouTube. We watch the trailers. We go through Redbox first. We find one that's like, what is this all about? Then we go look at the trailer on YouTube, and then if we like what we see, we watch the movie. And sometimes we just pick one and watch it and hope for the best, and we usually get some pretty good ones. A lot of cool vampire movies and mystery movies, sci-fis and things like that. And they're free. There's nothing, no sign up or anything.
We watch a lot of apocalyptic stuff as well, you know, like world-ending type stuff.
Oh, yeah, I love that stuff.
There's some stuff on YouTube. And as soon as you watch one, you'll end up with a load more in your suggestions. And these films are sometimes like an hour long, well, about an hour and a half, sometimes to 2 hours long. And some of them can be a little bit on the knob cheese side.
little?
But they're really, really good films, you know, compared to the crap that you watch every day now. You know, I'm so tired of those Marvel films. Storylines are just getting worse and worse.
Oh, the superhero thing, it's been done. You know,
yeah,
you know,
and I used to love stuff where people had superpowers or something special about them. But now I'm just like, bored of them.
Well, the characters are getting stupid. They're doing stupid things. They're doing things that are impossible. It's, you know, it's, I understand that's a superhero genre, but come on. Enough's enough. Let's move on.
And we watched, what did we watch the other night? We watched Dracula from...
You mean Van Helsing?
Yeah, Van Helsing.
That's
yeah.
a wicked movie. That's
yes.
cool as hell if you haven't seen
Not
that.
Not bad at all.
That's an awesome one. Yeah, the chicks are hot, too. I don't know about when they turn into friggin' vampires, but it's cool, the effects. They open their mouth and their jaws go real long, like Donna's face. They drop down real long.
Like my face.
And their fangs get
How
about 4 inches long.
How can you talk
about
long-facedness?
Man. They are bad, man. When they do that effect, though, with their face. Remember when they cornered that girl and they went, and their jaw dropped way down? That was cool, man. First thing I thought of was your face. Like, how long is that thing? Look at that. You could easily do that. You didn't realize we only got about 7 minutes left?
Oh, my gosh. Stop talking. You're talking a load of shit.
All right. Let's do one more tune here. Let's do Steve's tune, and then we're out of here. How's that sound?
Go on, then.
Like a wiener?
Like a wiener.
Okay, a wiener it is. Yankee to Brit, Friday night.
Yankee and the Brit's the place to be. Radio living is the life for me. Airwaves spreading out so far and wide. Keep your FM, just give me that internet side.
Online is where I'd rather stay. I've got a lot of music to play. I just adore a Yankee view. Darling, I love you, but give me a show to do.
The chat.
The brats.
On air.
That's fair.
You are my wife.
Goodbye, British life.
The Yankee and the Brit on air.
Like a jail, I wanna bust out and run like hell, never looking back until I reach those hills. You're the great Smoky Mountains, the thought of you gives me the chills. I need a tailgate, a jar, the river in my guitar on a bonfire Saturday night. If I don't take a little time for me to unwind, I'll never get the feeling right. I need a cane pole, fishing hole, catfish on, here we go, you know what I like. I need a laying low, good old down home southern night. Me and my baby working like some slaves. My kids need fed and my bills need paid, and I'm working overtime, just trying to survive. Yeah, yeah. They call it living the dream, even when it costs you your life. Well, I need a tailgate, a jar, the river in my guitar on a bonfire Saturday night. If I don't take a little time for me to unwind, I'll never get the feeling right. I need a cane pole, fishing hole, catfish on, here we go, you know what I like. I need a laying low, good old down home southern night. Chance I can get. I don't give a damn what the boss man says. My truck is all packed. I'll be there in a few. Yeah, yeah. Well, I don't drink often, but baby, now when I do, well, I need a tailgate, a jar, the river in my guitar on a bonfire Saturday night.
Steve Hickman. Yankee and a Brit Friday night, calling it a night, baby.
We are gone. We are out of here.
I can never see, never see buying a DVD. If that's your gig, that's fine. I'm just saying, I could never do that. I can't see spending the money on that stuff. You watch it one time and get rid of it, and it just sits.
Well, it depends, because I'm like one of those people that I forget what I've watched. So so it's like watching it. So it's like, two or three years later, I could put that DVD in, and it's like a whole new film I've never, ever seen before.
I guess. Well, anyways, we got to get out of here. Say goodnight, Donna.
Good night, Don. Hey, say goodnight, Randy.
Good night, Randy. There, you feel better now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good night, everybody. Love you. See you tomorrow night for Country Saturday Night with our guest,
Scott D. Harris.
Bye-bye.